Look at this diamond ring from Zales. What you see is not what you get. I say this all the time, but it bears repeating. When you look at this picture on the website at Zales or many, many other diamond merchants, that's not the diamond you're getting. This is an artist's mock-up. It's not going to look that clear. And I'll tell you why. They say it themselves. It's right here. It's color J and it's clarity I3. That's a pretty yellow diamond for a white diamond, J color, and I3 is just off the charts with inclusions, which is the fancy diamond seller's word for flaws, black marks on the inside of the diamond. Now, every diamond, except the most expensive diamonds, does have inclusions in it. They have flaws, so that's not terrible all by itself, but an I3 clarity diamond is very, very flawed. And let me show you how I found a much better diamond ring for much, much less. And I'll put the links in the description. Here we go. Let's do it really quickly. Well, let's look here. This is an I1 diamond. This is an I1, not I3. I3 is two clarity grades worse. Okay, so let's just look. This is an I1, and I mean, if you it's big, it's a one, I mean, fairly big. It's a 1-carat diamond, and it has a big old flaw right there. You can see that big black mark right there. That's just I1. An I3 clarity diamond is going to be even worse. So let's go back to the diamond selection page. Let's look for here's an I1 right here. Same clarity grade, but it does the flaws in it. Every flaw in a diamond counts towards or count like counts against its clarity grade. And so this one has supposedly by the professionals. Let's see who graded these. The GIA graded this one. I'm going back over to this really ugly I1. And who graded it? The GIA. These people know what they're doing, and they're very trustworthy, and they're like the refs of the diamond industry. And so, whoops, wrong diamond. We're going to look at this one right here. So, I trust them that they found enough flaws in this, maybe less dark flaws. These look kind of gray. I'm seeing some in here. But it's a much better looking diamond. Right, same, yeah, this one has kind of cloudy flaws in it, I can see there. So that's why I recommend you get this diamond that I'm gonna select. I'm selecting this diamond, and I've already selected an engagement ring, a setting, and it's here for 820. And I found this diamond for you. It's H color, which is better than J color. And it's I1, which is two whole clarity grades better than the I3 diamond at Zales. And this is only, well, 2000, let's call this 2600. Okay, 2600 versus the Zales, which was $100 more, but it's an I3. That it has worse clarity grades. And again, this is not the diamond you're getting. This is an artist's dream of a perfect looking diamond to me. I mean, it looks like that maybe you can spot, if you really use your imagination, one tiny little dot there, but that's more like a, kind of a refraction deep in this made up diamond. You're not seeing the individual diamond here. These are a bunch of, this an inventory of I3 diamonds. And I mean, I don't want to be rude, but because people are buying these for their marriages and so on, their engagements, and I feel kind of bad, but I'm going to say it because you haven't bought it yet. This is going to be an ugly diamond. I'm just saying, okay? It's going to be an ugly diamond because it's J color and it's I3 clarity. And they're not making it, like clear what you're getting here. They're making it look awesome. So this with James Allen with the diamond that I found for you, you are getting exactly what you see here. This is the diamond. They run it through some sort of, I don't know, automatic, photo taker, and they scan it from every angle, and they create this 3D, this image that you can just turn round and round and just fall in love with, that's the one you want, okay? So I'll leave the links in the description. You're welcome. You've just saved $100 and you've got a much, much better diamond ring for your lovely.